So good. Stephan Moccio co-wrote Miley Cyrus's power ballad Wrecking Ball, as well as a bunch of other chart toppers performed by The Weeknd and Celine Dion. And Stephan has just released a new album of his own, which is perfect for these challenging times. And he joins us now from his home in LA. Stephan, thank you so much for joining us. Before we get to your new album, can we talk about Wrecking Ball? Massive hit.
What would you like to know?
Well, you started off to writing the song for Beyonce. Is that right?
We did. You know, a lot of people sometimes don't realize that you get world-class songwriters in a room. And Sasha Scarbeck, who's from the UK, and Mozella McDonald's from the United States. I'm Canadian. We all got in the room and we didn't know each other. And we were asked to try to write a song for Beyonce. And at the end of the session, we had completed the song and just felt that Mozella said to the two of us, he said, "Hi, guys, I'm going to be seeing Miley in a few weeks. Do you mind if I play the song for her?" And she did, and the rest is history.
Poor old Beyonce, she missed out, yeah. But Miley did well. You began your career writing for TV. Is it true you can make more money writing for television than, you know, having a massive hit song?
I mean, don't get me... That's a whole other conversation about the royalty stream, and especially in the day of streaming, because, you know, songwriters and artists have lost a lot of money. But yes, I mean, writing for television is, you know, when you have a theme that's being played 10 times a day, 15 times a day. I write the hockey theme, the baseball theme, the news themes for Canada. And, you know, those things go on in perpetuity and they play for a long, long time. So a lot of people don't realize how blessed we can be sometimes. But I mean, because it's a really tough time for artists right now to make a living in these times right now. Mm-hmm. It was already difficult prior to COVID. It's more difficult now because there's no touring.
Yeah, it is really tough for a lot of artists at the moment. You got your first big break with fellow Canadian Celine Dion. A New Day Has Come was your first big hit. Were you writing for her or was that for someone else as well?
No, that one was for Celine. And okay. I was really young. And Celine, I go way back. We're both French-Canadian. And I told her when I was a young boy in university that one day I'd write her a hit song. Fast forward almost 10 years to the day, I end up writing her comeback song after she'd taken a sabbatical after having a baby. And that was my first big hit. That changed everything for me, and that kind of put me in the game, the world game of, you know, songwriters and the rest. Again, everything just kind of happened after that song.
How do you write for a huge superstar like Celine Dion, or when you were first writing for Beyonce? How do you know what is going to sound great for
you?
Don't,
I mean,
how do you tap into that?
The irony is they start off as piano melodies. Like take A New Day, for example. Wrecking Ball was a piano melody as well. And I start my writing typically at the piano. If the melody's strong, that feels good in my hands, then oftentimes it's those kind of melodies are just easier to write, you know, a lyric to. And you know, if I'm moved by it, chances are millions of people will be moved by it as well. But listen, I mean, it's not that easy. I mean, I craft these melodies. I spend sometimes days, weeks, months just kind of obsessing over them. So it's and some of them just happen, but some of them, like I said, they take a long time. Great.
Now you've got this amazing new album. It's called Tales of Solace, and it features songs to soothe listeners. How did you find the right tone for it?
The right home or the right title?
The right tone, the feel.
You know what? It was very, very easy, Angela. I mean, the thing is, I was tired. You know, 2018, I was cutting strings for Celine Dion in London, England, and I was just already itching to come back to something simpler. You know, it's not all as glamorous as we all, you know, to be a pop writer for who I am, it's amazing. But then after a while, you're constantly servicing other writers. You're in support of them. Yeah. And I don't always have full creative control. And honestly, my life was just kind of complicated. It was big. I was going through some personal changes. And I wanted to come back to just one instrument, the wood, the piano, and you know, instrumental music is perhaps the most universal music in the world because it has no lyrics. So finding the tone was rather simple because I was feeling it in my heart pre-COVID that I needed to strip everything out of my life. you know, living in LA is a big city, and a lot can happen when you experience success. Balancing success is a challenge at times. As it may sound strange to say that, but I want to just come back to something that was really authentically me. That's that simple, just the piano.
There's a great song on your new album. It's called Freddy's Theme. I think we've got some of it now. We're going to play.
Oh, there's the wine glass.
How did this tune come to you?
I'm a huge fan of Freddie Mercury and Queen, and after seeing the movie Bohemian Rhapsody, I was reminded that Freddie's love of his life was Mary Austin, a female, and clearly Freddie was a gay man, but I thought there was a bittersweet story, you know, it's beautiful tragedy to the fact that he couldn't fully commit to this woman being gay, but yet he left his entire estate when he passed away to her. And at the end of the movie, that there was just that beautiful love affair, that story between them. They still remained, you know, each other's best friends throughout their entire lives. And I thought there was just something beautiful about that story. So I came to the piano and I wrote this beautiful, tender theme. And I called it Freddie's Theme. In honor of Freddie.
Well, you can hear that and a whole lot of other songs on Tales of Solace on the new album from Stephan Moccio. It's out now. Do you mind playing us a little something to the break, Stephan?
Absolutely. The song's called Whitby.